Molly sounds like that sweet young girl next door, but her real name is E, X, or Ecstasy. She's old, she's been around the block, and she's not the nice gal that you think she is. Hey guys, Trace here for D News. The club drug Molly has been in the news a lot lately, what with Miley Cyrus and other pop stars singing about it, and two deaths at Izu in New York over Labor Day weekend. But before we get too into this, I want to head some of you off at the pass. Molly is E. Molly is ecstasy. Molly is MDMA. Molly is a generic name for a powdered or crystallized form of MDMA, or methylene dioxymethylamphetamine. The US Drug Enforcement Administration classifies it as a Schedule 1 substance, which means it is highly dangerous, has no acceptable medical use, and possessing any amount of it is completely illegal. And powdered, by the way, powdered does not mean pure. MDMA was created and patented in 1914 and was famously used in the 1970s by psychotherapists due to the drug's strong effect to lower inhibitions and anxiety. In the 1980s, the drug known as E or X began hovering around the house club scene until, in the 90s, it became clear that ecstasy was being cut with things far more dangerous, addictive, and toxic. Now in the 20-teens, the drug has resurfaced as Molly, in part because of the concerted effort by the drug sellers to rebrand it as purer, powdered form. Let me assure you, scientists, drug users, and drug dealers alike have all gone on the record to say no, that is not true. MDMA is an amphetamine or a stimulant and a hallucinogen. MDMA alters your brain's neurochemistry, bonding with the structures that release and absorb brain chemicals associated with mood, so serotonin, dopamine, and norepinephrine. This immediately induces feelings of euphoria, closeness, and diminished anxiety, peaking after an hour or two and usually lasting 4 to 6. Once people pass their peak, some will hit more and more to maintain that high. After the flood of chemicals abate, your serotonin receptors are just worn out. This is manifested by a depressed mood and extreme fatigue, often a day or two later. Outside of the brain, the chemicals cause the rest of your body to go into overdrive, causing high blood pressure and body temperature, or hyperthermia, which can then also cause kidney and liver failure. Often people on ecstasy drink lots of water, thinking their biggest danger is dehydration, which they're kind of right, that can be bad, but too much water intake combined with lots of sweating causes blood sodium and electrolyte levels to drop, resulting in confusion, delirium, convulsions, and maybe even a stroke. The icing on this happy little cake is MDMA usually is not sold by itself. It's often cut with ketamine, LSD, speed, or anything that you crush into a white powder. In combination, these drugs are extremely toxic to the human body. Now, in its pure form, like actually it's pure form, MDMA is relatively safe as drugs go, but it can be habit forming because as your neurons become immune to large amounts of serotonin, it requires more drugs to get the same high. Overall, deaths from this old gal are pretty rare, though since 2004, the number of hospital visits have more than doubled to around 20,000 a year. So does knowing all this make you think twice about trying it? Let me know, and thanks for watching D News today. Stay safe out there, everybody.